the angle's an inch and a half thick, so that's why we cut the track 3 inches shorter, okay? Because we're going to have angle at the ends to hold our, as clips to hold the box beam in place. I'm just gonna mark on the stud so I know where to stop the track. Obviously the door opening is 40 and a small 3/4 it looks like what he laid out. So I'm going 45/8 on the box beam. The clips, okay, there's an 8-inch stud, so the clips are 7 3/4. Okay, 7 3/4. Okay. First thing is to get the track. First track on, and it's gonna be right. So you want to just make sure it's good in the in their center. This is where clamping technique comes in. I'm gonna clamp through the knockout, okay, in the middle. Work my way out to the end, so I'm gonna clamp it right in the corner like that. Yeah, right inside like that in the corner. See if this is centered, which it is. You can see the front, okay, like that, okay. And the track is centered on my lines, like, okay. Fronts of it, right? Okay, since this is a small box beam, I'm only gonna do that once and then I'm going to the ends. But if it was a big long box beam, you would go at the 2-foot knockout, clamp each one, and work your way out to the ends. Okay. I'm gonna clamp that too, right in the corner. Okay. It's a crucial step. Keep your box beam like square. Right in the corner. Square two, I'm gonna add a couple more screws in between. Oh, not a rock. And I don't need to clamp them. Knockout center, but there's still a couple, and it's not a big box beam, so I'm going to the knockouts and instead of just going to the ends, just to get it square in to the track. You see how it snugs in when you clamp it in the corner like that? Okay. Middle. Top one, because we need to stud above, it goes like this, okay, the opposite way, so we're just gonna center it again, get it on the one side, nice and flush. So when I go to install, these are gonna hold it in place. I'm gonna put one on the top, at the bottom of each side on the door. So